Good morning and welcome to join my session. I am really afraid this session might be the most boring session within this, presentation within this event. Because I'd like to talk about something about legal and something about compliance or those kind of issues. But I'd like to give you another, one of the quite unique, maybe, aspect of what we are thinking about. So my name is Ueda. I am working for Sony as a Chief Open Alliance Manager. But my history of the open source is something long. I have been working for the, not only for Sony, but for the open world, that is the establishment of the CE work group, or used to be a CE Linux forum, since about 15 years ago. Until then I am working for, something like a promotion of the Linux or many of the open source software to be used, embedded system. Especially, maybe you know that many of Sony's products are another, consumer electronics vendors' products are now using a bunch of open source software, including, of course, Linux and many. And within Sony Corporation, I have something of the mission to make some of the training for the open source software appropriate to use some of the advisory of the open source software strategy. And I'm getting to be so busy because of the bunch of products, a bunch of people are aware of the importance of the open source software as a quite strategic, stuff. So this time I'd like to talk about something about the use of the open source software, but I'm quite frankly speaking, it's a bit, boring story still. Many people ask me about the appropriate use only the open source software, but only using open source software will not be so much, interesting thing. Maybe it's missing some important thing, which I'd like to mention. Of course, I know the open source software license compliance thought about appropriate use is really important thing. But and I know many people do not understand appropriately. And also, somebody is making big misunderstanding that use of the open source software may cause litigation, which will be totally false. And I'm performing the internal technical training course for the open source software appropriate use. And I have prepared about 180 pages of the text. And also along with the 350 pages of the slides. It takes about 8 hours to go through. And somebody gave me that nickname of this training course as an Ueda's open source software bootcamp. And, well, I will never say that, push up for the 20 times if you fought, if you wrong this, and in this, question or something. But I will never let those kind of audience to sleep. Maybe I think everybody will have a great, understanding of the why it is so important. And this presentation is mainly quoted from those kind of, training course. But unfortunately, it is not decided to publicize a whole bunch of the training course at this moment. But we are gradually thinking to disclose those kind of, presentation material. And within the training material, I have start this kind of question: what is a license? And I sometimes give this question to the attorney or legal staff. And everybody starts thinking something, but I am thinking the right of the software authors are protected by copyright law. It's quite essential thing. And it is saying that Therefore, the author of the software have some right to make a grant of the use of the open of those kind of copyrighted material, and how to express those kind of conditions to grant. That is written in license. So that I think the license, this is my my understanding, but license is something of the document of describing the intention of the copyright holder, the condition of the use, and the what will be intended to letting them use of those kind of copyrighted material. So that reading through the open source software license or some of the software license is really important to get to know the intention of the licensors. So without reading precisely about the open source software license, it is not allowed to use that kind of maybe copyrighted material, which may be quite risky. And for the many cases, the licensor's intention will be described within the license precisely, so that only to do for the licensee to understand the licensor's intention is read carefully about a license, software license. It's quite simple. And many of legal or some of the attorney can do it because they are quite accustomed to get read of those kind of license text or some of the legal text. But the case of the open source software license is a little bit different because the person who writes the license term and licensor is a different person. For example, the GPL. GPL is prepared by, of course, that Free Software Foundation. And of course, Free Software Foundation itself is some software licensor. But for the many cases, the licensor, GPL license software, not always the Free Software Foundation. Think about Linux. Linux is copyrighted by the Free Software Foundation, but many of the people. So here might be existing some sort of the paradox. The licensor is always borrowing the license text from some certain person, like a Free Software Foundation, to use. And also, those kind of licensee always, try to read the, license text precisely. But that I'm afraid there's some gap. Because not always the licensor itself is fully, conveying from the license text holder's intention, like a Free Software Foundation. So that just reading the open source software license will not suffice to understand the licensor's condition. That is underlying the within the open source software license itself. So that some of the legal person or attorney will become puzzled because just reading open source software license may not suffice to get to know the licensor's intention. That is some of the quite fundamental problem. So it means that just simply reading or not suffice. It means that we have to find a way to know, another way to know the licensor's intention. That is maybe to get close relationship with a licensor or the community. So it is quite essential to read the open source software license term carefully. It's, of course, quite essential thing. But it will not suffice to understand the open source software licensor's intention. We need to understand the OSS development community's intention with some another way that will be how to participate into the community, maybe. So some of the legal or IP department person will get the concern that should we participate in community? I am really good at reading the license term or some of the copyrighted law or something like that. But I'm no software engineer. I have no chance to get into the community. Then I have no way to understand the community intention. They may say, of course, they are quite accustomed to read the those kind of text, but their expertise will not set upon some of the software engineering or to know the software open source software community. Of course, there are several exempted people who are quite well acquired of the technical background and the community background with the legal or attorney license or that kind of thing. But that's quite exceptional. So maybe we can trust those kind of people to read the term precisely and make some of the good suggestions, but we need something to follow them up. Many of the software engineers of the engineers regarding the legal and IP department person like that. If we ask something to legal or IP department, this is something of the open source software licensed under this term. Please analyze some of the risk or some of the things we should consider. Then they will say, guess what? Not only this, they will say some fear included. So we cannot criticize those kind of people because it is the some of the mission of those kind of people. But software engineers themselves know the way to communicate with the open source software development community. Why it is the community releasing the open software under open source software license, or what are the anticipation to the users, or something like intention of, or some dreams or something like that, we can know. Maybe most of the audience here will be software engineers or those kind of technological backgrounded people. So, we are always making this kind of appeal to the Sony employee that is think about the people developing the open source software when we use the open source software. Try to appropriately understand them. Not just of course, it is quite essential and important to read the open source software license term, but we mustn't forget about these kind of things, and also, we'd like to try to become some of the appropriate and good citizen within this community. Apparently, it's fact. That is some of the top sentences, top charts of the chapter of the open source software training course within Sony. I'm saying that never stray from the right path to, or do something devious. So that this kind of relationship of the trust in between open source community and company will make us, both of us, happy, I think. And the most, worst thing is like this. Somebody tried to use open source software, but never try to hide the fact of the use of an open source software. It will cause really bad situation. And we have to use the open source software quite open and quite, with some of the owner or something like that. We should be proud of use the open source software in open way. We should not attempt to hide the use of the open source software. So that forming the legal or IP staff and software engineers, especially who knows the community, who have a talent of the community relationship, will be quite essential to use the open source software appropriately. So that the first step we should do within each company is how to make some of the internal community in between the legal IP staff and software engineers, especially who knows the open source community. And we, those kind of collaboration will be able to make some of the reporting to the person who can judge the use of the open source software, and they will be able to make appropriate business judgment. Then we will be able to use the open source software quite appropriate way. So that quite essential thing is if we can make up this kind of internal community or not. For Sony's case, we have established two types of open source community. One is the open source software license committee. That is a committee in between the legal person and software engineers from all the business units. And another committee is named Sony Open Source Board. Sony Open Source Board is a board to make a promotion to letting Sony's engineers to participate into the open source software community or making a donation of the open source software code, which is developed by within the Sony as an open source software. And maybe you will be able to see the Sony's official GitHub site, that is github.com/Sony. And of course, that is not still the starting phase, but actually the project within the Sony official GitHub site is increasing. And I know that many of another company, advanced company like Microsoft or Samsung, Intel, or those kind of company have a bunch of projects disclosed from the that kind of GitHub site. But we are going to make some catching up to those kind of advanced companies. Anyway, that kind of internal community will be quite essential, I believe. So this kind of discussion will make a good result, and the quite essential thing is how to make a mutual trust each other. And this kind of phenomena, environment, will have a quite appropriate situation to use open source software. So then, risk will be removed. Well, we'd like to aim at this kind of situation. Three important things is one is encourage software engineers to participate into the community and create in-house community, and tell what the open source software development community is intending. Like sometimes Lina Stoppels is making some of the comment in the mailing list or something, like Linux community is intending something blah 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 or something like that. That kind of explicit information is quite useful to understand, to let those kind of understand who are not participating into the community. And also those kind of information is not something like not tacit but something like implicit. So that we have to encourage as much engineers or as much people to participate into the community. And we have to say a great thanks to the Linux Foundation or those kind of persons who are organizing this kind of opportunity to make a very, very intensive relation, communication and collaboration hooking a point, like embedded Linux conference, or LinuxCon and open source summit or those kind of events. And also, we are making a proposal to the software engineers showing something like quite shocking slides. Isn't it quite shocking? This slide will more shocking, one, I think. Of course, it is intentional. Do not think the bio computer or this kind of Sony-related computer is like this, unstable computer, but it is intentional slides. What we should do? Well, this must be a worst case that I'm lost. I don't know what kind of software with embedded into this product, so that I have no way. That kind of thing will become quite an awful situation. If it happens upon some of the vulnerability or some of the quality issue, we Sony will lose our reputation from the customer. And of course, if it is related to the some of the suggestion from the outsiders of the concern of the open source software license compliance, that well, this kind of situation will make a quite terrible situation.
So that. We must,
this is a quite, base fundamental, requirement for the daily life of software engineering to record what you did, the record of the structure. Structural management is one of the quite important things. This is not only the for the sake of the open source software license compliance, but of course it is quite essential for the quality or some of the vulnerability issue, which is quite essential and important. Do not make any black box within each product or each software, software application software or some software packages. And if you'd like to take some of the new open source software, well, somebody will always say that, here's a good open source software. I checked the Google or something. Here's a good code. Copy and paste immediately. That kind of behavior will make another mess. So that this is a picture which we are always saying, hey, I found cool software on the website, on the street side. Do not drink it. It may be poison. It may be something quite, malicious or something. So that assess first whether we can use those kind of software or not. Of course, one aspect is the quality aspect. Another aspect is the, maintenance. If the, software is not supported by some of the activated community, maybe we have to worry for some of the maintenance issue. Of course, in some cases, we take something of the open source software which supporting open source community is not activated. To that case, maybe Sony will try to activate those kind of software or its open source software community. And maybe we are starting several projects to activate those kind of community. And also, open source software license compliance is another aspect. If we take some of the software which Sony cannot make the open source software license compliance, maybe we mustn't take that kind of software. So that if we intake those kind of software from the outside, we have to be reminded like this picture. So, software configuration management is really important and never hide the fact of using the open source software and evaluate the open source software when you intake. That's quite important and essential thing. We are emphasizing to the software engineers as well. And also we are thinking about how to deal with the external communities. I mean that the supply chain is another important issue for us. If the supply chain people have appropriate knowledge and behavior, and Sony have appropriate knowledge and behavior, and Sony have also have the appropriate knowledge and behavior, it may be okay, but both poor, that will become a really miserable situation and well no way. And even if the Sony have a well, trained and well understanding the open source software, people dealing with those kind of, supply chain issue, but without the collaboration with the open ODM, OEM partners, we cannot do appropriate, behavior to it. And in some cases, it's something embarrassing for Sony, but we have a good, suggestion. We got a suggestion, good suggestion from the OEM, ODM partners, and we are paying a great thanks to those kind of people. And of course, we should aim at this situation both Sony and both OEM ODM partners have a good understandings. And of course, one of the quite essential things is that how to share the idea of the principles of the using open source software.
And maybe I think the principle of using open source software
is which I have already described, that think OSS community first and the follow the quite essential thing of the open source of the other software engineers. So now we'd like to make us another try to make this kind of sharing the impression, sharing the idea of the quite essential thing with the Sony's partner companies. It's the starting phase, and we'd like to make another progress. Of course, we are thinking that the SPDX or open chains result is quite useful, and we'd like to use those kind of result as well. And we'd like to add Sony's original way of thinking, as I have already mentioned.
So that I hope every partner companies also establish internal community of the legal IP staff together with the software engineers who know the open source community well. And this kind of networking of the ideas will make both OEM, ODM manufacturers, supply chain people, and Sony ourselves happy. And of course, in order to make, convey the actual information about the use of the open source software, SPDX is quite remarkable and useful. And I hope the Linux Foundation to help both legal IP staff and also the some of the provide the opportunity to make a community relationship advisory to be vitalized. And of course, this kind of event is a really good event to make this kind of, fostering those kind of people who to know the open source software community reality. So this is another thing we are thinking as some of the vision, like making the OEM, ODM supplier, legal and IP expert and
client ourselves together to think and together to make some of the trust of use of the open source software and relate with the community. So this is a quote from the Ibrahim Haddad said, Samsung people said, that appropriate use of the open source software, it is the engineering issue which is required legal help. And it is quite, good word. And I'd like to say thanks to Ibrahim. Well, I'm forgetting something more important. That is, I'd like to introduce what we have experienced within Sony. This actually happened. Several years ago, we started using one open source software with some of the bug fixing. But unfortunately, we hoarded those kind of bug fix within Sony. And quite recently, it happened. Another bug was reported. And also that was, of course, causing some of the vulnerability problem. We are obliged to make a version up to the latest version. And when we evaluate that kind of latest version, we found it that the bug which Sony already, found it out and fixed is still there. But the situation get to become the worse than we have expected in the older version. Every engineer said, why I did not make the contribution of those kind of bugs to previously. We made that kind of bug fix, donation to the expert, those kind to the good community people. Community people may make some sort of the maintenance together with those kind of bug fix. But they have lost the way to do it because Sony didn't make the contribution of those kind of bug fix. So we have learned one moral with this situation. And now we set up one of the corporate inside regulation that is making this kind of bug fixes to the open community. We can make a really, really simple
approval to be taken, and we can make it quite instantly. And of course, that is subject of the judgment of each managers or each engineers themselves. So that we'd like to make another promotion of those kind of things, but we are on the way to make it anyway. This kind of thing, I'd like to recommend you, every of you, to do it. And this kind of situation may happen, not only within Sony, but also within your company. So that donating the simple bug fix will make a future of ours happy. But without doing that kind of thing, we'll lose this kind of happy situation. But anyway, just using the open source software will not suffice and will not cover 100% of the advantage of the open source software. Well, just wait someone to do something. That will not quite, inactive way. Well, for example, you know that Sony is now going to use intensively the NATX. The 2 years ago, we have started evaluation of NATX, but I found it that NATX, the community of NATX is not so much activated, but performed by some of the quite limited people supporting the NATX themselves. So that if we are the company which we look for someone to do something, just waiting someone to do something, maybe we have no way to judge the use of the open the use of the NATX. But we have decided we should make another way of saying that make a contribution, not just waiting somebody to do some of the evolution of that kind of open source software. Then Sony got another freedom of the use of that kind of software because we decided ourselves to become the one of the person of the community of the NATX. And of course, unfortunately, because of the limited human resources, that kind of activity is not yet sufficient, but that is laying behind within us, judgment of the NATX to be used for our products. Of course, community people will not be so cruel and just waiting or just, asking something to do for some kind of community. That will also be allowed. But sometime, maybe community people will say that I'm not a free of charge servant of you to create software. So go together with the community. That will be quite important thing. Not just wait somebody to make the evolution of the certain open source software, but involve it. That's right, together with soaring to the sky together. That will make software engineers happy. OSS community is a place to make collaborative, collaborative creation and innovation. And it is a place to learn how to make the innovation or how to foster the next generation software engineer who are required to have the, idea or skill to go together with, partners, not solely by themselves. It is so complicated in the world, so that only single, genius people have limited chance to make an innovation. But a teamwork will make another, resolution. So I'd like to come back some of the early stage of the open source software for embedded system. We have decided to set three, stages of the open source software for the embedded system people. One is, of course, the mainline community. Another is that we have encouraged every people to jump into the mainline community initially, but every people, especially Japanese people, are too shy to jump into the mainline community. Oh, it's really embarrassing. My this kind of jump purchase, I cannot speak English. What? I cannot speak English. What language are you speaking? I'm speaking English. Well, that kind of funny thing has always happened, but no one, you know, challenged to make a, you know, contribution to the community. But so that we have started to, you know, have the place of the international place to get together the person who are interested in the embedded system. That is embedded Linux conference. You know that ELC is now performed by the, Linux Foundation, and every springtime and autumn time, we can get together globally in America and in Europe. And we also holding one another event, that is Japan Technical Jamboree. Japan Technical Jamboree is allowing them to speak in Japanese. And we have not given the name of the technical conference to that kind of event. We named the event Jamboree. Think about the Boy Scout people surrounding the campfire and speaking out quite freely about their dreams or their fault, their mistake, or those kind of things. Ah, you made such kind of mistake. Well, the teacher may say something quite tough thing for you. Next time, we'd like to do this kind of thing. That kind of thing will be talked around the campfire. That kind of atmosphere I'd like to try to produce. And it's quite happy, but many people understood this kind of a situation. So that it's something like a hop, step, jump strategy. Hop into the Japan Jamboree, that is quite free space to speak Japanese, three places to speak, even with the competitors' companies, because it's a open source field. And next step is ELC in the United States, the US, and Europe, and then jump into the community. This is one of the strategy we set up: hop, step, jump, strategy into the community. And it's quite happy that that kind of strategy seems to be working well. And we are counting 60 times of the upcoming next Japan Jamboree. The schedule is March 17. And I hope to make a summary review of this kind of history of 60 times of the Japan Jamboree at next opportunity. Maybe I hope it happens in the embedded ELC Europe, if the organizer approved in my session proposal. Anyway, this is all for my presentation, and hope it to be useful, and hope it to informative for you to think something about it. Especially, I am proposing one of the way that the open source software license is something quite unique one, which is not always saying the same as the ordinary software license. That is because the person who prepared the license term is not the person who are making the open source software as an to the public sets. I mean the licensor. Licensor's intention is not always covered within the license term itself, but we have to make some of the additional way of thing to consider to get together with the community itself. It's all. Thank you very much. If you have some suggestions or some of the comment or question and discussion, please go ahead. Thank you very much, Sozo.